Welcome to our spiritual equipping show with Dani Johnson. Discover strategies on how to get what you need and want out of life as Dani uncovers life-changing scripture from the Bible.
This book, the best success book ever written, the Bible, is really the chief author and finisher of how you will succeed.
Zero in on the positives in your life and with God's help, defeat and eliminate the negative aspects you endure with the Dani Johnson Show.
Welcome to the Dani Johnson Show. We really are so blessed that you decided to join us today. And today I believe that you are going to receive such a great blessing because today is the day that we focus on spiritual matters. And today is a day where great obstructions are going to be taking off of you. You know, we all have obstructions to our success, whether you realize it or not, friend. We do. And oftentimes we are blinded to what those obstructions are. And we might be having challenges in our finances, right? It seems like there's more month left over and not enough money. Or it seems like some hidden bills decided to pop their ugly head up just like the boogeyman did when we were kids. You know what I'm saying? It's like, well, I wasn't expecting that. And that kind of catches us off guard. Either that or we're going through some troubles with our marriage. Maybe it's that time of the season of the woman's cycle and, you know, there's cat fights going on inside the house between you and your spouse or she and the kids or whatever, right? Whatever way that it goes. But sometimes there's obstructions that are in our lives and we can't even see them. And I know that today we are going to expose an obstruction that was in my life, probably still is, that God is actually working me through right now. You know, not too long ago, it was September 17th, the show about Do You Provide Service with a Smile? Now, again, this was a spiritual focus of a show, just as today's is going to be. And in that program, I talked about a sermon that I had heard. I'd gone to church on a Sunday. We had a different speaker than normal. And he had given these 3 points. Well, these 3 points are still getting me. The day that I actually heard the message was August 10th. And look at us, we're already in October, and bam, I'm still like marinating on these 3 simple points. And to be honest with you, next week's program is also going to have the same kind of a flavor. So it's kind of like part 1, 2, and 3. Today is going to be part 2 of what we talked about on the 17th of September. So I'm excited to bring this to you, and I'm excited to talk about it. And I just want you and I to have a heart-to-heart today. Because whether we realize it or not, there are roadblocks, there seems to be some potholes, even speed bumps, all out giant walls in front of us. And I know I have found some recently I've found some throughout my entire last 2 decades of walking with this God that I serve. But this is one that's been like, you know, reared its ugly head. And I'm excited because I'm getting better. I'm getting on the other side of this thing, and I'm going deeper inside of a very important message that is vital to our success. It's vital to your financial success, your business or your career success, your family success, your health, who you are in the community, and who you are if you are one of those that actually taps into a church. It really has an impact on those things. So since today is a spiritual matter, I'm kind of inviting you into my living room, and I'm a praying woman. In fact, I pray throughout the entire day, and I pray for you every single day. Me and a whole team of people slug on heaven's doors every day for your life, for your family, for your business, for your career, for your finances. We pray every day that God parts the Red Sea for you. We pray that He heals your body, restores your relationships. I mean, we really do care about you here at DaniJohnson.com. So let me just pray. And by the way, at the end of the show, we are going to spend a lot of time taking your prayer requests and praying with you one-on-one for as the time permits. So Father, I thank you. I thank you. I thank you for today's message. Lord, I pray that you are the one that speaks. Let my words fall to the ground and die. Lord, let not any one of my words or my view of what I'm saying penetrate anybody's heart, but God, let it be that you're the one that knocks on the door of our hearts. You're the one that gives us ears to hear today, and that you move us to great change, great improvement, great success. Lord, you said that if we diligently seek you, you will give us the desires of our hearts. So we're seeking you today. We're wanting to learn from you today. We know that you're the author and finisher of our faith. We know that you are the one that makes a crooked way straight. We know that you are our redeemer. You are our releaser. You are the one that reconciles us to you. You are the one who set up all of the laws in the universe, and you are the one that reveals what those are to us so that we can play the game to win instead of constantly losing. So, Father, bless my friend who is listening to this program right now here today. Bless me as we go to deliver the message, and let us have ears to hear you speak. In Jesus' name, amen. Okay, so remember, these 3 points have been killing me, okay? In fact, I saw the man who delivered the message at my church last Sunday, and I just put my hand on his chest. He was sitting down, and I said it to he and his wife. I said, that message you gave in August is still getting me around my neck. It will not let me be. And he's like, what, the authority of Christ? I said, no, that I didn't even hear that part of it. It was those three things, these three things. What were those three things? Give up your rights. Humble yourself and serve everyone. Deny yourself and pick up your cross and walk with me. That was, again, that was like three small parts of this huge message that he gave. And really, the huge message that he gave, the context was not about those three parts. It was simply just a lead in to a whole nother message that I still haven't heard because I was too busy crying and writing and journaling. But I believe this is going to help you and me today. It helped me when I re-went through my notes again today. And I know that as I go to speak it to you, I'm going to get helped some more. Because we all need help, right? We all have struggles. We all need encouragement. We all need to come out from bondage. We all need to come out and away from and detach ourselves from a yoke of obstructions that are in our lives that we can't even see. So I hope that today is going to reveal an obstruction, and you are going to see it, and you're going to be done with that sucker. That's my hope, and that's my prayer. So we're going to focus on number three today, right? Because I kind of went over the give up your rights. I was talking about the rights that, you know, I felt entitled to as a mother and as a wife. Hey, you know, I've worked so hard your whole life. You can at least pick up after your dog. You know what I mean? These rights, you know, that I'm the mother, I should be respected. I'm not saying that I shouldn't be respected, but I shouldn't be entitled to it. You know what I mean? It's a bad attitude that I had there. Yeah, really bad. Anyway, so we're going to focus on part three today is what we're going to focus on. And that's the deny yourself and pick up your cross and walk with him. Okay, let's just focus here. Deny yourself. What? Deny yourself? Yuck! I have to tell you, when I was writing this, when I was receiving this, who I believe I was receiving it from the Lord, my stomach was in knots. It really was. Deny myself? I got to tell you why. Because I think higher of myself than I should. That's the facts. That's the facts. I think higher of myself than I ought to. Do you? I know I do. I know I think of myself too much, which means I'm thinking higher of myself than I ought to. I think most of us do. Most of us think about ourselves all day long. We think about what we like to eat, how we like to eat it. We think about our favorite colors. We think about what we are interested in. And here, this deny yourself, man, it grabbed me by the throat and by the gut and deny myself? Oh my gosh. And so when I look in the scriptures and it says, right, that we're supposed to cast down every lofty thought and that we're supposed to hold every thought captive and make it obedient to the Messiah, Yeshua, Jesus the Christ. And that means every thought, right? And so if I think of myself all the time, then I think of myself higher than I ought to be, even if I have negative thoughts about myself, right? Especially in my early years, I was very self-condemning and very self-critical. And now I'm not one to puff myself up, but the fact is if I'm thinking about myself all throughout the day and even through the night, then friend, my thought is lofty. Who is supposed to be the reigning thought in my life? Not me. Not me, but we are to think of him. And he says that his thoughts are higher than our thoughts. I think part of that reason is because we think of ourselves constantly. We do. We think of our desires if we have plans, which I know a lot of people don't have plans for their life. But if we have any plans, we think about those plans all the time. If we have goals, and I know a lot of people don't, but if we have goals, we think about those goals all the time. Or if somebody has hurt us, we think about how we've been hurt, right? And how we feel. When we're hungry, we think about what I am craving and the kind of food I like. And I don't care what the price is because I want this and I want it now. Or I like that blouse, or I like that suit, I like that pair of shoes, I like that new iPhone, I want a new computer. You know what I'm saying? We think about ourselves. It's almost as though we have built a kingdom wrapped around I and me and myself. And that in itself is a form of idolatry. And so this passage that I came across, and I believe it's in Proverbs, about thinking higher of ourselves, and I might be wrong of where that's at, but it's in the Bible, the best success book ever written. But you and I both have encountered people that are much like myself. I really got convicted when it came to deny myself. I really did. I was like, that was a heavy weight. Deny myself? Wow. I'm a self-absorbed pig. What I think about and how much I think about myself, right? Look at it. This is where I'm bad. I like my routines. I like the way my food is cooked, meaning I like the way I cook my food, which is why I don't like to go out. Why am I going to pay 7 times more money for food that's lesser than the food I put on my table? Ew. Not to mention, I give better service to my family than any restaurant's going to give my family. This is ridiculous. So I like my food cooked a certain way. Therefore, I am going to cook it, right? Okay, what about this? How we like our houses to look, right? Like, I like my house to be in order. I like things to be dusted. I like them to be clean. And by the way, I'm the one that takes care of that. Twice a month, I have somebody that comes and does the really heavy duty stuff. But every day, it's the pickup time. I like my laundry room clean. I hate it when there is folded clothes or even dirty clothes in the laundry baskets and clothes hanging out of the baskets. I have this way about myself of I'm a very particular, I like things done a certain way. Okay, think about the clothes that we like to buy. We have this certain taste that we like. Why? It makes us feel good. It's just the way we like to be served. When I was writing this and journaling this, I literally put my journal down on my stomach and I almost went and threw up. When I looked at all the I in my house, I just was sickened by what I had seen in me. But there's a good side to this story. Continue with me and we'll get to the other side where we can move ourselves out of the way, the biggest obstruction in our life to our success, and get on that greater path. This is Dani Johnson.
Join us as we spend more time together to understand God's will in our lives here on The Dani Johnson Show.
The whole story of how I went from homeless to millions is right here in this book, First Steps to Wealth. I'd love to give you a free copy of this book. Just dial 888-757-8880. You can get your free copy of this book. It's like a real book, my friend. You can get an ebook copy for free right now, or if you'd like to pay the shipping to get this $15 book to your house, I'd be happy to send it to you. 888-757-8880. Get your copy of First Steps to Wealth today and begin on a brand new path of some great success.
We're back. Here's Dani Johnson.
Deny myself, Dani Johnson? Are you serious? Deny myself? I work hard for my money. I deserve everything. I deserve for people to treat me right. Gosh, I don't know who you think you are, but wow, you know, Jesus was sinless. He loved people. He did what was right and noble and pure and praiseworthy. And yet he was mistreated. I don't care how good you think you are or how good I think I am. I don't care how good I think I treat people or how good I might lead in business or how good I might treat my spouse and my kids. It doesn't matter. The fact is we have all fallen short of the glory of God. We're all a mess. And I think if we all came to grips and really took a strong look in the mirror as to who we really, really are, we're a bunch of filthy wretches trying to put on some crazy facade. So when I've come across this passage in Matthew 16, 24, right, Jesus says, if anyone wishes to come after me, he must first deny himself and pick up his cross and follow me. I don't like that. I don't like that at all. Especially, come on, I was just telling you like how selfish I am. This passage just really showed me how like, wow, oh, I need to change this. I think higher of myself than I ought to. I'm awful. Look at this. Even with my laundry, okay, the laundry that I do in the house, it has to be done a certain way. Why? It's the best. Can you hear Nacho Libro talking to you? It's the best. I like the way I do laundry. I have a system, and the system works. And don't mess with my system. Ugh. That means that I'm not the easiest person to live with, obviously. Or what about in business, right? I'm talking to you business people or those of you who are in the workforce, right? Look at it. Like, don't mess with my system. Listen, I have a certain way of spending. I have a certain way of making decisions. And don't mess with my flow. Don't decide to jack up the protocols that I've put in place. No, you need to do it this way. Right? Gosh. I'm telling you, when I was reading this and when I was praying through this, I mean, I was disgusted. I was absolutely disgusted with myself. In fact, just the part that I just finished reading to you took me 30 minutes to write down. Why? Because seriously, I came off of my little couch on the floor, on all fours, head on the ground going, oh, Lord, ouch. This is painful. I'm terrible. Ooh, I mean, I seriously got a picture of my disgusting self. And I consider myself one to serve others. But boy, do I have some things that need to change. That's the bottom line. You know, I kind of hate this feeling, but at the same time, I kind of love it, and here's why. Because whenever God convicts, he lifts us up to be able to make the changes. You see, God is not one to condemn. That's what the enemy does, and that's what man does. But God is the one to convict, and conviction means that he lifts us up. He exposes a weakness inside of us. He exposes an error not to go, you idiot, you stupid jerk. No, he does. He's like, this is an obstruction in your life. This is hurting you. My love, my dear one, this is hurting you, my child. Can't you see that this is actually creating problems? This is creating stress in your life. This is not making things better. It's making things worse. And so that's what I love about him. What I love about our God is that not only did he send his son, Yeshua, Jesus the Christ, to die for our sins, but if we open up our hearts really to him, then he gets inside of our hearts and he starts cleaning house. He does. You know, all those hidden things in those closets, all those things that we do that we don't realize that we do, those blind spots that we have that cause us to create problems for ourselves and other people, those things that we keep hitting our head up against the wall, well, that's exactly what the Lord was revealing to me, is that I have some things in my life that have to be laid down, deny myself, pick up my cross, and walk with him. So I don't know if he is speaking to you right now, but I know this, some great changes and some great stresses that I didn't even know were there are being lifted off of me. And I believe he's doing the same thing inside of you as well. Again, he's a father. He's a loving father. He's working inside of your heart to clean out the junk that hurts you and hurts me. Removes the big obstructive things that are keeping us from our destiny. The very thing that he created us for, that he predestined us for. We've got these habits and these ways of thinking and these ways of acting and these laws that we've written inside of our own hearts that he did not write in there. But he's saying, come on, agree with me. Let's move this sucker out of the way called selfishness so I can take you to a greater place of great success. This is Dani Johnson. We'll continue after this.
Don't just stand there. Soak this up. It's joy. It's encouragement. It's insight to a better life. And how to meet your obligations and overcome obstacles.
The Dani Johnson Show.
This is The Dani Johnson Show.
You want to succeed, right? But you do not want to fail God at the same time. There is a way to succeed from a biblical perspective, and it's far greater than anything you could ever imagine. Over 500 scriptures I studied to study money, everything that the Bible said about money. That's in the first couple chapters of Spirit-Driven Success, not to mention leadership, working with people, growing a career, being used mightily in the marketplace, which is where Abraham, God used him in the marketplace, and Joseph, God used him in the marketplace, Moses, God used him in the marketplace, Daniel, Solomon, really all the greats of faith, most of the greats of faith throughout the Bible, they all were in the marketplace, and God wants to show you how you can be used mightily by him in the marketplace. Right here, Spirit-Driven Success is where all of my notes are on how you can do that. 888-757-8880. Again, 888-757-8880. Get your copy of Spirit-Driven Success today.
Now, more of the Dani Johnson Show.
When I first came across this incredible passage that was written in the best success book ever written, the passage says this: if anyone wishes to come after me, this is the Savior talking. Yeshua is his Hebrew name, Jesus, the English form of the Jewish name. He says, if anyone desires to come out, wishes to come after me, he must deny himself and take up his cross and follow me. When I first heard that passage, I got fixated on the cross. And that's what I want to go into now. Like, what did the cross actually represent? What did that cross represent? What did it actually mean? Right after he was beaten, after he was beaten to a bloody pulp. Have you ever seen The Passion of the Christ? You need to see it. So you get an idea of the kind of beatings that the Romans gave their victims at that time, or in this case, he was wrongly accused, but the prisoners, these are the beatings. This was the torment, the torture, the blood, the blood scattering, the broken bones, the lashings were just unbelievable. They put a crown of thorns on his head, and then he is told in all of this weakness, right? Could you imagine? I mean, I remember getting beaten by my stepfather when I was a kid and being the breath being kicked out of me. I remember that. I remember not being able to breathe when we'd have his hands around my neck, shoving me up against the wall. I remember gasping, trying to get my next breath. I remember the horrible words that my stepfather would scream at me. And I remember those things. But it's nothing like what Jesus endured, right? So here he's just had this horrible lashing, and he's told to pick up this cross, and it was actually a tree, right? It was limbs of a tree put together, this heavy, heavy thing. And he was beaten, by the way, for you and me, for our sin. He was the sacrificial lamb who shed his blood to cover us. And so now he's told to pick up this cross and carry it a long ways to the top of a hill where everyone would see that he was being crucified as he was being crucified for something he did not do. He was falsely accused and bearing the price of it. And so when I really started to look at this, I started to make a list of things. What did the cross represent? And this is just what was revealed to me. And I want you to look at this because you might be going through some of these things right now. And he's saying, deny yourself and pick up your cross and walk with him. So here, one of the things, he was publicly humiliated. Here was the king of the universe who left his heavenly dwelling place that was filled with wonder. He put on a man's suit, born of a woman in a manger, and he came and he served the people. He had no place to lay his head. And here he was publicly humiliated. Have you ever had that happen to you? I've been publicly humiliated. I remember the first time in a classroom, I couldn't read. I was made fun of by the teacher. And of course, the whole class is laughing, crying out my eyes, running out of the classroom, running into the bathroom. I just never wanted to face that teacher, and I never wanted to face those students again. I remember being chased by three girls, three bullies, week after week after week. I was humiliated as I'm running, feeling like I'm running for my life away from these three girls who are hunting around for me like a lion hunting for their prey, hurling terrible, mean-spirited words over me. Public humiliation is nearly unbearable. He was naked. He was stripped naked. A man naked in public. Come on, think of it. Being publicly humiliated. No one was standing for him. His friends that he spent the last 3 years with, who said they were devoted, who watched him perform all of these miracles, and yet what happened? They forsook him. They left him. They denied him. This man that they passionately loved, that they even sacrificed many things for, their businesses, their reputations, when the hour of need for someone to represent him was there, they turned. They betrayed him. They left him there, not defending him, not helping him, not screaming out for help for him. Even his own brother. Now, again, in their defense, they didn't know what to do. Man, they were crying. They didn't know what to do. And many of them just ran off. But could you imagine you're being accused of something, you're facing death, and there's no one there to come to your aid, to come to your rescue, to come to your defense? What about being falsely accused? Has that ever happened to you? It's happened to me. I know it's happened to you. Especially if you are a believer and a follower in Yeshua, Jesus the Christ, you know you have been falsely accused, lied about, okay? No one defending you. He was broken in every way. His body was broken for our transgressions. What about the emotional pain? Have you ever endured emotional pain? See, this is what the cross represents. This is the cross. It had emotional pain, and it had physical beating, flogging, the spilling of blood, being deeply hurt. Come on, you and I have been deeply hurt. You know we have. So deeply hurt that it takes our breath away. So deeply hurt, we're crying like thousands of tears. We cry so hard, we don't even know if there's any tears left, right? What about being totally taken for granted? Here he came, and he was the Messiah that was prophesied for 1,500 years. He was talked about, he was prophesied by the prophets, and yet here he is dying for the very people who are falsely accusing him and beating him, who I wish I had the words to articulate. You understand what I'm saying? I hope you're getting the picture of what I'm saying. They forsook him. They took him for granted. Have you ever been taken for granted? You know you have. I have. What about being misunderstood? He was completely misunderstood. They thought he was a criminal. They treated him as a criminal. They beat him as a criminal. And watch. He wasn't a criminal. He was sinless. They put his body up on that cross along with two other thieves, right? Have you been misunderstood like that or something close to that? Betrayed by those who once were devoted to you, said they'd always follow you. What about the appearance of being defeated? Oh gosh, the agony of defeat. It's agonizing, isn't it? And that you're being defeated in front of everybody, the whole world known, that knew you, knew what you stood for, and yet you look like you have completely lost it all. You in front of everybody, what a terrible embarrassment. What about being mocked? Being mocked, laughed at, spit upon, stripped of all dignity, publicly mistreated, and last, and I know there's far many more things that this cross represented, but denied proper justice. He was denied proper justice. I know that you've been through one or two or maybe all of those 18 things I mentioned. But have you gone through them all in the same day? No matter how bad things might be right now, my friend, I do know this. It can't be anywhere near as bad as that last 12 hours of Jesus' life. I know beyond a shadow of a doubt that it's not that bad. No one has ever suffered what he suffered through based on who he was and the authority that he had. There's not been another man like him on the earth, nor will there be until he returns. So even if you've been through, you know, 5 of the 18 things I've mentioned or 17 of the 18 things, or if it's all 18, I know it hasn't been all in the same day, all in the same 12-hour period. I'm confident that it hasn't happened to you like that. So the cross that he's telling us to pick up, that he's telling us to deny ourselves, deny our right, the entitlement, our selfishness, deny ourselves of our own wicked selfishness and pick up this cross and follow him. He's telling us to humble ourselves. He's telling me to humble myself because he is my defender and he is your defense. And he's the only one that can defend you. And he's the only one that can make all things new. Because there's another side of the cross also. There is. There's a whole other side of the cross, and that was the result of the cross. But when we're in this place of hurting, we have to come to this place of looking at his life and making the choice to follow him. Because in him is the only place where we will find rescue, refuge, redemption, and reconciliation. He's the only one that can bring the refreshing and the new breath inside of our nostrils when we feel like there isn't any left. He asked us, and it says this in Matthew 10:38, and he who does not take up his cross and follow me is not worthy of me. Don't you want to be worthy of him? I do. I do. But we can so easily play the card of the victim. We so easily can play the card of entitled, that I deserve this and I deserve to be treated like that. And doesn't everyone see what I'm doing? That simply is just a sign, my friend, that we have a huge ego. And we got to get our ego out of the way if we want to have any kind of peace and harmony and success in our lives. We have to stop defending ourselves. I remember one of my spiritual father saying to me, "Will you let the defense please rest? Will the defense please rest?" Wise words from a wise man who encouraged me that Jesus is my defender and I don't need to continuously be entitled and defend myself. This is Dani Johnson. We're going to get on what is on the other side, the blessing of the cross, right after this.
Hey, have you done a favor for your best friend yet? Then do it now. Share this program with them. The Dani Johnson Show, helping hundreds of thousands of people just like you make life more enjoyable and rewarding. The Dani Johnson Show.
I'm so blessed that I found what is in Grooming the Next Generation for Success. This is a book that is being taught in universities around the world. It's been noted as the best book on parenting that has ever been written. Crazy, if you ask me. But the point is that this thing gets results. Get your copy today, 888-757-8880. Again, that's 888-757-8880. Or go to DaniJohnson.com. That's DaniJohnson.com. Get your copy today.
Get ready to live the uncommon life. Here's Dani Johnson.
There is something else that the cross represents. It's not all bad, right? The cross simply is saying to you, if you're going through any of those horrible things that Jesus went through on that last day of his life, well, meaning his physical life before he ascended up to the Father after he rose from the dead, what I am saying is that that is speaking to you and me today, that we have got to humble ourselves. We have to humble ourselves. We have to surrender to the cross and know that he paid the price for our sins. And if we're being falsely accused and mistreated, hello, he said that if we want to share in his blessing, we also have to share in his suffering. And I know a lot of people don't like to talk about that suffering. They don't. You know what? Unfortunately, in the American and the Canadian and the most of the English-speaking part of the world and most of the modern church today just wants to sell the blessing. And that is really what they're selling for an offering, of course. Sounds very similar to the early days of the Catholic Church that was selling these basic entitlements as well as they were selling, if you want to be blessed, you want to be saved, you got to pay money to be saved. If you want your brother to be saved, you got to pay money to be saved. It's kind of like the same thing. Unfortunately, every success message that is preached from every motivational speaker with the title of pastor that is out there, not all churches are like that. And I think there is a place for motivation. In fact, motivation is a spiritual gift. Interesting. However, there is a suffering that comes along with success. And see, Jesus did win. He did win. He sacrificed everything to win. And what did he win? He beat the devil. He beat him hard. He beat him bad. And he defeated him. He defeated death by rising from the dead. He defeated the death and the darkness and the disease as well. He overcame everything that Satan represented, and he is still alive today. He's still alive. The grave is empty. And so what does that mean? That the cross has another side to it. That yes, there is suffering in the cross, and you might be going through that suffering right now. And guess what? You will also, if you suffer with Christ, you will also reign with Christ. And we're not worthy with him if we are not willing to pick up our cross and walk with him. So here's a few things that the cross also, and this is what the Lord ministered to me, that the cross represented, is that it represents a deep and everlasting, huge purpose. So the suffering in which we endure, that we might be going through in this season in our life, and by the way, it's just a season, this will pass, things are going to get better, this isn't the way it's always gonna be, right? Because now you gotta flip that crossover and go, what's on the other side? A deep, everlasting, huge purpose. What was the deep, everlasting, huge purpose? Hello? Total, complete defeat of the enemy. Complete victory for all of us, for billions of us who choose to pick up our cross and walk with Jesus. So what is it? There's healing in the cross. There's healing in the cross. There's restoration in the cross. There's miracle in the cross. That's also what the cross represents. The cross also represents victory over your adversary, defeat of your adversary, rising up and being strengthened to stand firm and to stand strong against your adversary. That's what the cross also represents. The cross represents life. An everlasting life for all of us who cling to him, rely on him, believe in him, confess him with our mouths boldly, not hiding that we are a believer in Yeshua, but boldly professing the truth of what he has done for us. Now, what else does the cross represent? It represents deliverance from pornography. It represents deliverance from guilt and shame. It represents deliverance from our debts, from our bad choices, from the consequences of our own sins. The cross represents, yes, deliverance and healing and restoration and redemption from all of those nasty, filthy, disgusting, wicked things we have done. Because as far as the east is from the west, he remembers our sin no more. The cross represents deliverance from condemnation and criticism of ourselves and by others. That is not to say that we are not going to be condemned by others. Oh, they may condemn them with their mouths, but guess what? No weapon forged against us will prosper. And every single accusatory tongue that has come against us will come down and it will fall. That is what the cross represents. It represents so much more than that, but I am simply telling you that if you are going through a suffering right now, stand firm, cling to that cross, knowing that he paid the price. And what is on the other side of this suffering? Redemption, victory. You win this one, friend. You win this one. It's not even halftime yet, so quit worrying about it. I'm talking to myself. It's not even halftime yet. The game is not over. We're not finished yet. We're on the path and in the journey of being transformed to the image of Christ. And part of being transformed to the image of Christ is going through suffering. That's why, you know, in Galatians, it talks about the fruit of the Holy Spirit being one of them, being long suffering. Whoo! Do you hear what I'm saying to you right now? You better hear what I'm saying to you right now. There's two sides to that cross. Which side do you want to be on? Which side do I want to be on? I know this, that the only way to get to that victory, the only way to defeat the adversary, the only way to put the suffering to rest is to deny myself of my own selfishness. You see, this selfishness is why we have all of this wickedness in the world. It is selfishness, our own selfish, lustful desires that drives us to buy things we do not need, that causes us to buy more cravings, more foods, more junk that kills our bodies. It is selfishness that causes us to gain the 100 pounds we should have never gained. Okay? It is selfishness that drives us into debt. Nuh-uh, Dani, my medical bills got me into debt. Friend, stop it. Stop it. What made you sick? Bad choices made you sick, and you know it. No, I was born this way. There's so much documentation out there of how you can take care of your body and/or he's a healer. So why don't you believe with faith that he can heal you so you don't have medical bills? Friend, come on. No matter which way we slice it, we are a product of our own choices. So what do you choose to follow? I'm making a choice this day, every day, hereafter this day, to deny myself of my own selfish, disgusting things that lead me into bad choices and, of course, painful consequences. I am going to choose to pick up my cross and follow him. And while I'm going through the consequences of my own stupidness or the consequences of other people's stupidness, because guess what? We live on earth with people and we do suffer from other people's sufferings. As I choose to pick up my cross and not feel sorry for myself, not have self-pity, and not be an idiot about it, but I choose for the hope and the glory of what's on the other side of the cross. And that is what? Redemption. Healing, forgiveness of all my sins, forgiveness of all of your sins. If you choose to trust in him, rely on him, lay down your life, he laid down his life for you, friend. He laid down his life for you. Lay down your ego, lay down your selfishness, and let him raise you up and exalt you. That is his promise. Father, thank you for this message. I praise you for this message, Lord, and I pray that it continues to marinate in me and marinate in my friend who just finished listening. In Jesus' name. We're going to be taking your prayer requests right after this, the hour two of this program. 844-200-3264 is our phone number. Again, that's 844-200-3264. Dial now, and we will get to that prayer request. This is Dani Johnson. We'll continue with more after this. This is your chance. This is your shot. Get your copy of War on Debt right now. There's one waiting for you that has your family's name on it. And inside that package is freedom, your family's freedom is on the inside of that package. All you have to do is open it up, press play, and start applying what I teach you in this program. 888-757-8880. You and I are going to help your family become completely debt-free in the next 5 to 7 years. Just imagine how that's going to feel.
Join us for a revolution in increasing your income, improving relationships.
You can make your marriage better. You can make your finances better. You can make your job better. You can make all of your relationships better by what you choose to focus on.
Expand your life experiences with God with a very spiritual equipping show from Dani Johnson.
Think on these things, that which is noble, good, pure, praiseworthy.
Here and now, the Dani Johnson Show.
Welcome to hour two of the Dani Johnson Show. We just finished talking about a message that has been like, getting me by getting my goat. Where did that statement ever come from? But it really is seriously getting my goat. Deny yourself, pick up your cross, and follow me. Man, you know, I don't know about you. I don't know if you came to a place of going, that you felt some kind of conviction about your own personal selfishness. I know I had tons of conviction on mine, but I am so grateful. I am so beyond grateful that, first of all, I get to talk to you like this. I get to get face-to-face with you like this, and we get heart-to-heart like this, and we deal with the truth. We deal with the selfishness of our own selves. We lay that stuff down. We drop our ego, and we decide to serve others. We decide to love others better and live by the example that Jesus lived. And even in our suffering, right, we have to know that we will reign with him. If we suffer with him, we are going to reign with him. And that is what I cling to. That is seriously what I cling to. Hey, we are taking your prayer requests right now. 844-200-3264 is the number. Again, that's 844-200-3264. And we are going to pray for this whole second part of the show. And you know what? If you're somebody that you have a heart to pray for people too, please stay tuned and pray along with me. There is a lot of people hurting right now. There are so many going through some horrible, horrible, dysfunctional things in their marriages, sexual abuse, pornography that has entered in these marriages, even people at church that are dealing with that stuff, pastors who are dealing with that stuff, not to mention some major financial crises, health crises, you know, a business that blew up, meaning like got bombed, you know, lost their jobs, lost a child, the kind of suffering that is happening all around us in our neighborhoods every day. even in the people that you work with every day. We have no idea. I just found out yesterday, one of my close girlfriends, her brother has brain cancer. Like, I had no idea that her brother had brain cancer. You know what I'm saying? So there's a lot of people that are really tormented and struggling. And so if you are somebody that has that gift of intercession, meaning you want to pray, please pray along with us. Stay here and pray along with us. So I'm going over here to, we've got New York, Allison on the line. Allison, welcome to the show. How can we pray for you today? We just lost Allison. Oh my gosh. Okay, we're going to wait, hopefully, for Allison to reconnect again. Anyway, listen, I got to tell you about this, too. Prayer is hugely important. It truly is. Prayer is something that actually gets things done. I don't know if you've spent any time on our website at DaniJohnson.com or not, but on our site, you will find a whole series that we've done on prayer. Not wishy-washy, little wimpy prayers, but we're talking like powerful, slugging on heaven's doors prayer. Open up, let me in here. Okay, I'm not saying screaming, but I'm saying that simply prayer is a really important thing to add to our lives. And as I read through the Bible, and I've gone through it nine times, as I've read through the Bible, there's something really profound that I found, especially studying King David concerning prayer, that he didn't start off his prayers with, Lord, if it be your will. There's a lot of exclamation marks in his prayers. You see that through the book of Psalms where he's like, you know, give ear to my cry. Hear, oh God, what I am saying. You know, don't you see me? I'm suffering. Like when I read that, I was like, the Lord illuminated this crazy, powerful truth. And it was amazing to me, like, wow, how we can so easily go and pray with no faith. And you know, that the bottom line is this, is if we don't have faith, then, and if we're not all in what we're asking God for, well, he's certainly not all in to deliver to us what we are asking for, or to deliver us from something. That's the facts. So we literally need to be somebody that goes all in, meaning if you've got a serious financial issue right now and you are in fear, don't bring your fear to the throne room of God. Bring your faith to the throne room of God. And what does that mean? The fact that you actually want to pray, the fact that you will cry out to God, the fact that you will call in today and get prayer is proof that you have some faith, right? And he says that all we need is a mustard seed of faith. That's it. It's a tiny little piece of faith. All right, we got Allison back from New York. Allison, welcome to the show. How can we pray for you?
Prayers in reference to I'm having trouble with financial issues, with rent and stuff like that.
Okay. What's going on financially, Allison?
I'm just not having enough to pay the bills, and I'm going to go to court for back rent. I just don't see any way to come out of it.
How much money are you bringing in every month?
I just pay like $390 a week.
$300 a week or $3,000?
About $390 a week.
$390 a week, okay? So that's roughly $400 a week is your take-home pay?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so this is now four times four, $1,600 a month. What's your rent?
$950
for rent? What's your electric bill?
Well, it depends. It verifies from month to month. If it's hot, about $95 to $100.
Okay, $95 to $100. So we're at $1,700 a month. How many people in the household?
Just me.
Just you. Okay, so you should be spending around $80 a month on food. Okay, so we are...
Just me and my daughter. Just me and my daughter.
Oh, it's you and your daughter. Okay, so then that means So it's $20, the average budget that we teach on our website for, you know, declaring war on debt and living rightly financially is $20 per person per week for food. So that means that's $160 per month for the two of you. Am I counting that right? 20, yeah, 80. 80 times 2 is 160. All right, so we were at $1,900. No, we're not at $1,900. I'm so sorry. So you said it was $950 for rent, $100 for your electric bill, so we're at $1,050. And we got $180, so we're now $1,200 a month for including your food. So what other bills do you have? Phone. What are you paying for your phone bill?
I only have a cell phone. I have $60 a month.
That's a lot, girlfriend. What are you doing with a $60 a month phone bill?
It's just what I have. I really can't stay long. I was at work.
Girlfriend, first of all, you need to learn how to budget because you actually are bringing home enough money to manage your finances and to make your rent. So the issue is, I'm going to pray for you, no question, but $1,600 a month, if you make $1,600 a month, you shouldn't be having a cell phone bill for $60. It's way too much. I would go get yourself a Go phone for $30 a month. Either that or you can the cell phone. You get, because you're low income, you can get low income for your telephone to be a landline at home for $20 a month. So that's something I'd be shoring up. Because on $1,600, I know it's a little bit, but you can make it happen. And it looks to me like you can actually have some savings as well, putting money away, at least $100 a month, putting away for something, whether it's for the rainy day or for car to get fixed or whatever. But let me pray for you. Father, I thank you so much for Allison. And God, man, this is a little bit of money that she's making in a city. And Father, I know I've been to New York. I know the expenses that are in New York. I know the transportation in New York. I know the bills. We have thousands of clients in that city. And God, I pray that you highlight to Allison the things of where she can save money and be faithful with the little things, Lord God, and then you will make her ruler over much, much more. Father, I also pray that you give her insight through job domination, any places that she can find some free materials on how she can get promoted in her job, be more valuable in her job. Lord, you said that skill brings success. That's what you said, God. And so, and you also said, Lord, that David led Israel with the integrity of his heart and the skillfulness of his hands. Lord, you are the one that led lays it out for us that you've given each of us a certain level of ability, and the way for us to increase our ability is to go out there and prosper with our ability, to work with our hands, to be faithful with the little things, to grow in our knowledge, to increase our ability. And as we do that, Lord, then you open up doors for opportunity for us. So Father, as Allison does those things, that she doesn't just settle for lack, she doesn't settle for poverty, she doesn't settle for what she doesn't have, but she says, no more, I'm tired of struggling, I'm tired of being in this place, and I must rise up. Father, show her that you are her God. Teach her, guide her, and have her get serious about growing her income and saving money and being faithful with the little things. In Jesus' name, I bless my sister in New York. Amen. Thank you so much, Allison. I appreciate you. Go to the website. There's so much free training on our site to help you with finances. There's so much free training on our site to help you with jobs. This show, man, almost every week we do a show on how to get promoted in your job. And so go listen in the archives on that and find ways to save money, because you seriously have a resource at DaniJohnson.com to show you exactly how to do that. And if you don't have the free book yet, let me give this to you. First Steps to Wealth. It'll show you all the budgeting things that I was just talking to you about. It's going to show you all the ways to get promoted in your job also. That's in the book, First Steps to Wealth. Write this phone number down, girl. 866-760-8255, okay? 866-760-8255. Call my office right now, and they will send you a free copy of First Steps to Wealth. In fact, they'll email you the ebook right now, so you'll get it immediately. But if you want the physical copy, and you know, if you're one that likes to write notes in the margin and highlight and dog ear and all that stuff, and if you want the physical copy, you pay the shipping to get it to New York from us, okay? I'll send you the $15 book if you pay for the shipping to get it to you. You got to have some skin in the game. So get a hold of this and follow what I show you how to do. What an awesome thing that you called in, and now you're getting a free gift. I'm sowing this into your life so that you come out of the poverty place I used to live in. It also has my story there, how I was a homeless woman and then started a business and became and made $1 million. So you can learn to do what I learned to do. There's no question in my mind. We serve the same God. You need to know the principles. I know you can raise up in your skill level, and you're not going to be in this dead-end financial place ever again as long as you follow what the instructions are inside of the book, First Steps to Wealth. So again, 866-760-8255. Follow it, girlfriend. And I promise you, your finances are going to completely change. You're going to give a better life to your daughter. You're going to show her a better way of living. And I know that I know that I know that God's going to do it in you. There's no question in my mind. Thanks so much for being here, Allison. I appreciate you. And you got to let me know how you enjoy the book and how your situation changes. Awesome. This is Dani Johnson. We're taking your prayer requests, 844-200-3264. Again, that's 844-200-3264. You know, it's really funny to me that we often can be a people that are continuously in financial need. Continuously. And somehow we think that the finances are going to fall out of the sky if we just pray. No, God blesses the work of our hands. He shows us in the best success book ever written, and that's not my book. That's His book, the Bible. He shows us exactly how to get promoted in our jobs. He shows us exactly how to grow our businesses. He shows us exactly how to become investors. It's crystal clear on how we can grow and actually build wealth if we're willing to learn, willing to try. This is Dani Johnson. We'll continue with more after this.
Join us as we spend more time together to understand God's will in our lives here on The Dani Johnson Show.
Hi, I'm Dani Johnson. The most common question I get usually are from people who are trying to juggle their life. They've got kids. They've got kids who are involved in all kinds of activities. They've got business or their job, finances, trying to get out of debt, plus all their church activities and all the volunteer activities. And they're pulling their hair out going, how do I juggle this all? Man, I once lived just like that until I learned Time Secrets. Time Secrets showed me how to be able to cut my hours from 100 hours a week that I was working down to 20 hours a week and tripled my income as a direct result with what I learned. Time Secrets also showed me how to get my priorities in order, which healed up my marriage, and I became a mother that I want now was proud of versus becoming the mother I didn't want to be. And so if you feel like your world is running around in all kinds of different circles, you can fix that. Call 888-757-8880. Again, 888-757-8880 for Time Secrets.
Your family, relationships, and business can prosper with the understanding of God's will for you and your life. We can help you on that path here on The Dani Johnson Show.
I don't know what kind of pain and suffering that you might be going through right now, but guess what? We have an answer for you. Yes, and the answer is maybe something that you are not aware of. It's a word that might even, detestable to you, but it's a word that has great power. Prayer, great power. Let's slug on heaven's doors together today and let's put an end to the suffering. Let's put an end to the hitting your head up against a wall and let's come into some great solutions. I have found that prayer is the quickest way for me to get out of my bad, sulky, pitiful attitude, out of my victimized mentality that I might carry once in a while, out of my, there's a lot of things I could say about myself right now, but I won't. This is about you and helping you get out of a pit perhaps that you could be in right now, or that you even just want to share something encouraging to everybody that is listening. 844-200-3264 is the number. Again, that's 844-200-3264. We have Mignon from Fresno, California. How can we pray for you today?
Hi, Dani. This is Mignon. Oh, this is awesome. This is the first time I've ever been on your show.
Well, thanks for being here. How can we pray for you?
Well, I've been doing a lot of advertising with my company, and it's been a long time. I keep getting a lot of no's, and I'm looking for, I ask God to send me the right people to work with me with my company and prosper and grow. And
you keep hitting a wall.
No.
That's the problem. You're waiting. The Bible says, ask, seek, and knock. Ask, seek, and knock. So I have a question for you. If you try to build your company with fear, you're going to reap what you sow. He who sows sparingly reaps sparingly. He who sows abundantly reaps abundantly. I want you to go at that business and building your company as though it is already successful. Faith is what people are attracted to, not fear. Impatience, people are not attracted to. Faith, they're attracted to. They're attracted to vision. So I want you to look at the places maybe that you might be cutting corners, or maybe things that God's been trying to tell you to do that you just are refusing to do. And go do those very things. So I think he probably has told you what you're supposed to do. And I think you need to go do it. So I'm going to pray for you. Father, I lift up my sister, Mignon. Lord, I've been in those shoes so many times. Father, I remember you clubbed me over the head with fine satisfaction in your work, and it was a time where I hated what I was doing. I hated the work that you put in my hands. I didn't like it. I had the worst attitude about it. And Father, I also remember the times where I was completely fearful as I was trying to build my company, and I was failing left and right. I also remember the times, Lord, where I was striving. I know you've seen all of this. You've seen me do all of these crazy things, Lord, as I built companies through the years, and all of those things turned into futile wastes of time and ended up in nothing. Father, I pray that you give Mignon the absolute clarity and the humility to do exactly what you're telling her to do. Father, I pray that she leads with faith, not with fear, not with worry, not with anxiety, not with striving, but that she leads with faith, that she does not lead with being impatient or with these parameters of it's not working and it needs to go faster. Father, I pray gratitude over my sister, that she is grateful to serve you every single day with excellence and diligence, Lord, and the places and the things that you have brought her to teach her how to increase her skill set. God, you're not a man that you would lie, and you will not be mocked. Your word is true, and you have said that if we increase our skill, you increase our success. So, Father, I pray that she gets teachable and hungry and learns new skill sets that will help her to produce an income that's greater than the one that she's making now. Yeah. And God, I pray that you also show her how to be a giver with the profits that she's making now, actually with the gross that she's making now. Whatever she's bringing in, that she takes 10% straight off the top and she helps other people who are far less fortunate than her, that she takes care of the poor. Father, I also pray that she learns to dedicate her company to you, that it's your company, it's not hers. You're the CEO of her business, and that you're the one that guides her each and every day, and she knows how much you love her, and she knows how much she is chosen by you, and she has a destiny, Lord God, that you do not have a desire to harm her, but that you have a desire to prosper her as she is willing to follow you and your ways. I bless my sister and her business this day. In Jesus' name, amen. We'll continue with more right after this.
Working to achieve happiness in life is not easy. Advice, life stories from callers on the air, solutions, a beacon of hope. Stay tuned for more of The Dani Johnson Show.
I just heard this amazing story. One of our clients had written us telling us that they had used job domination and unlimited success and has absolutely exploded their career. He said, Dani, I don't know where I'd be today without job domination and unlimited success. Listen, do you want more recognition from your coworkers? Do you want to be recommended to people all over the world? Do you want to be somebody that is highly sought after? Listen, if you're in a dead-end place where this gentleman found himself but then learned new strategies and changed everything in his work life, and obviously this has resulted in higher bonuses and pay raises, you're next. 888-757-8880. Get your copy of Job Domination right now. 888-757-8880. Again, 888-757-8880. Job Domination. That's what you need. It's time for you to dominate the job market and break through the rut that you're in.
This is The Dani Johnson Show. And now, here's Dani.
This is Dani Johnson. Thanks so much for joining us for this part of the Dani Johnson Show. We have a spiritual focus one day a week, and that's today. And in fact, we've been slugging on heaven's doors for the last 30 minutes on behalf of all of our faithful listeners. I don't know if you believe in the power of prayer. I know that's kind of corny and queasy in some cases, but it really works, I promise you. Man, prayer has dug me out of the most impossible situations, as well as crushed my most impossible bad attitude that I've had from time to time. And the things where I've become hopeless and completely helpless and I've lost all dignity, prayer has been the thing that God has used as a tool in my hands to dig me out of a pit that I somehow dug for myself, or maybe I fell into someone else's pit. Have you ever done that? Stinks, man. Absolutely stinks. But prayer is the way to get out of whatever bad situation that you might find yourself in. So we're going over to the phones. We got Margie from Texas on line 2. Margie, welcome to the Dani Johnson Show.
Thank you very much. I'm asking for prayer today, for financial reasons, and also I'm looking at an opportunity to kind of start a business. I'm in a company now that I work for somebody else, but I feel a calling and have felt it for over a year to start a business, and there's just fear there that's kind of keeping me from doing that.
Right. Okay, two things I want to address concerning that. Number one, you know, God showed me something many years ago that that he's actually had to show me again and again and again, and this actually just came up in my own life. And you know, when I was a kid, I was one of those spiteful kids, right? Now, I grew up in a really bad abusive home. I was emotionally, violently, physically abused. I was mentally, verbally abused. I was sexually abused. So I had a major chip on my shoulder, and I was one of those fighter kids, right? And so look at our God, right? He takes what the enemy intends for bad, and he flips it around, and he uses it for good. So, you know, if when I was a kid, you hurt me, I am so going to get you back. Margie, were you that way as a kid?
Absolutely.
Oh, I love it. See, what are the odds, right? What are the odds? What are the odds that you and I are on the phone right now together, right? What are the odds that you actually made it in the queue? I mean, there's five people on hold right now waiting to get in on the show to get prayer, and that you be the one that the Holy Spirit just tells me to tell you this spiteful story, right? So again, I was a spiteful one. It's like, you take that from me, I'm taking something of yours. You know what I mean? It's like, you said that about me, I'm going to say this about you. You punched me, I'm going to punch you back. I'm going to punch you twice because you punched me back. Okay, well, check it out. I believe this is totally a word from the Lord. I remember one day just being so overloaded with fear. And it was during a time, actually, that I got embezzled in a business. I was completely embezzled. I lost it all. It was right after I made my first million, right? And I remember being so crippled with fear. Like, I couldn't muster up enough faith to get out of bed, let alone to go to the office, let alone build that business. But yet, there was the calling, right? That destiny was calling out of me saying, come on, honey. Come on, you got this. Come on, you got this. I'm like, no, I don't. I'm going to fail again. I'm going to hurt again. I'm going to be betrayed again. And I remember the fight and the oppression that drove me into a deep depression because I allowed it to. And all of a sudden, the Holy Spirit woke me up and said, what do you think the devil is trying to keep you from doing? Why is he working so hard on you to not do the thing that's calling you? And in a moment, Margie, I went, ooh, ooh, okay, all righty then. You pig! That was what came out of my mouth. You pig! You are such a liar! And as soon as I figured out that the devil was the obstruction in my life, stopping me from my calling, that business that was calling out to me, I went, done! And this is what I said to him. I said, you know what? I know you're not supposed to talk to the devil. You know what? Just because you've been trying to stop me, I'm going to just do it anyway just to see what's on the other side of this thing. So God literally took the spite that I had as a girl and as I had even as that young adult that was right there, and he used that spite against the enemy. Do you know what happened to me after that? I had the greatest successes that I had ever had in my whole life up to that point.
Wow.
So just know this, that calling is from God, okay? So you got to wonder, why is the enemy working so hard? Because God is not the author of fear. He's the author of faith. He's the finisher of our faith, right? So I want you to start that business in fear. Sometimes we got to play afraid, right? Sometimes we just got to, all right, man, I'm doing it just because you're trying to stop me, man. Here we go. And I don't care what happens. Just because you've been fighting me, I'm just going to do it anyway. I know you got that in you, Margie. So, Father, I thank you so much for Margie. I thank you, Lord, for your Holy Spirit and your word of knowledge that you gave me. Father, for her, you didn't give it to me, you gave it to her, that, Lord, she is indeed being called to a business. Listen, thinking about it for a year, praying about it for a year, that's wisdom. That's wisdom. And at this point, now it's fear. And at this point, it's about obedience. It's about obedience. So, Father, I pray that you give her strength right now to punch the nose of the enemy and go forth boldly, knowing her calling and knowing that success is in her path for that business that she knows you have brought to her. So, Father God, in the name of Jesus, I pray wisdom over her. I pray knowledge and understanding over her. I pray a blessing over this endeavor. And God, I pray that her feet are shackled with the gospel of peace, that you're going to bring her to a people in the business world that do not know you. And she will proclaim your goodness. She will proclaim your mercy, your grace. And she will proclaim what Yeshua did on the cross for her, Lord, that you're going to use this business as an opportunity for the gospel to be spread in the highways and in the byways for the people that will never know you, that will never walk in a church. They're going to see Margie and they're going to see Christ in her. They're going to see the faith inside of her, and she's going to have the opportunity to lead people to you. God, I bless that. I bless that. I bless that. I bless that. And also, Lord, I know that she's going to give to the poor. She's going to use this business to fund the kingdom of heaven. So God bless it that she gives $1 for every 10, not to a church, unless the church is taking care of the poor, but she is going to give it to the orphan, give it to the widow, give it to the sick, helping kids come out of the sex trade, that her business is used for a great and mighty purpose. I also bless her leadership, that she'll lead by example, and there'll be many that will flood to her by that example, Lord, just as many flood to Jesus. And Lord, you said if we hold up your name, you'll draw people unto us, unto yourself. Through us, they're going to come to you. So Lord, I just thank you that she's going to hold up your name. I thank you for her boldness. I thank you for the gospel of peace that's shackled at her feet. I thank you for the sword of the Spirit in her hand, the shield of faith to fight against the fiery arrows of the enemy. I thank you for the impartation of spiritual faith landing inside of her spirit right now. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen, amen, amen.
Amen. Thank you so much.
You are so welcome. Thanks for being here. I'm excited for you. Now go and sin no more. God bless you, Margie. All right. We're going over to Daniel in Springfield, Missouri. Welcome to the Dani Johnson Show.
Thank you so much, Dani, for taking my call. I would like to ask you to pray for me for spiritual breakthroughs.
Yes.
I need to learn how to forgive myself and how to love myself.
Yes. You know what? I want to talk to you about that. That's been a common topic recently in my community, or in the community that we live in. And, you know, forgiveness is final. Forgiveness is final.
Mm-hmm.
So learning how to forgive yourself is as simple as just forgive yourself and release yourself, Daniel. Release yourself, because when we don't forgive ourselves and we don't forgive others, then Jesus won't forgive us. And when we continue to pick up and return, when we continue to return to our own vomit, now we're saying, Christ, what you did at the cross was not good enough. It didn't work that time. No, it did work. Daniel, the fact is it is the enemy that likes to remind us of our past.
Right.
It's the enemy. He's the accuser of the brethren. That's who he is. And you are in Christ, obviously. You're talking about forgiveness. You're asking for prayer to forgive yourself and to forgive some other things. So that means that you are a Christian, right? You do profess the name of Jesus, right?
Right.
And he is your Savior, right?
Right.
Okay. And you know what he did at the cross, right?
Right.
What did he do on the cross, actually, Daniel?
He died for all our sins, all our transgressions, for our healing.
So let me ask you this, Daniel. All of whose sins? Can you say it personally? All of my?
All of my sins.
Mm-hmm. I want you to say it again.
All of my sins.
All of your mistakes.
All of my mistakes.
Yeah. He forgave you. And his blood was perfect. It washed you clean, making you as white, pure snow. No spot, no blemish, no residue. His sacrifice was perfect for you. I want you to hold the line. As soon as we come back from this break, I am going to pray for you and everybody else that struggles with this topic of forgiveness.
Whatever hurt, pain, trial, or situation you're fighting or fighting through, you've come to the right place. You are not alone. Stay tuned for more of the Dani Johnson Show.
You want to succeed, right? but you do not want to fail God at the same time. There is a way to succeed from a biblical perspective, and it's far greater than anything you could ever imagine. Over 500 scriptures I studied to study money, everything that the Bible said about money. That's in the first couple chapters of Spirit-Driven Success, not to mention leadership, working with people, growing a career, being used mightily in the marketplace, which is where Abraham, God used him in the marketplace, and Joseph, God used him in the marketplace, Moses, God used him in the marketplace, Daniel, Solomon, really all the greats of faith, most of the greats of faith throughout the Bible. They all were in the marketplace, and God wants to show you how you can be used mightily by him in the marketplace. Right here, Spirit-Driven Success is where all of my notes are on how you can do that. 888-757-8880. Again, 888-757-8880. Get your copy of Spirit-Driven Success today.
God's solutions, spiritual solutions. Here's Dani Johnson.
You know, there are things that we have a tendency of struggling and wrestling with. I was recently with a girlfriend of mine in Denver, Colorado. She's a pastor. And I heard her say, I don't know, dozens of times, I struggle with that. I struggle with that. And I said, why? Why would you want to struggle with that? I said, that's like going over to a piece, a dog made a mess on the floor, and you are willingly going and picking it up with your bare hands. It's still hot. It just came out of the dog's body. And you're wanting to pick that thing up. Why do you keep struggling? We don't have to struggle. We do not wrestle with flesh and blood, but we come against the principalities of darkness. Our wrestling is not with ourselves. It's not with another person, but our wrestling is with the principalities of darkness, who, by the way, if we are in Christ, there's no condemnation in Christ, and therefore we can defeat those principalities of darkness. So I said to her, why do you keep struggling? Why do you choose to struggle? The fact that you keep saying that means that you're going to continue to struggle. Life and death is in the power of our tongue. Right now, we've got Daniel from Missouri on the phone. He was just calling in for prayer. And he's saying that he is struggling to forgive himself, that he needs help to learn how to forgive himself and forgive others. Well, we're going to go through a real quick lesson right now. Daniel, let's go ahead and go there. The enemy is the one who reminds you of your faults. You see, he does not know your future, Daniel. He doesn't know your future. He only knows your past. That's all he knows. And he doesn't even know all of your past because, you know why? He's not omniscient. He's not omniscient. So he wasn't there on every one of your sins. Could you imagine if he was? The long book that he would have, right? The long, long book that he would have. But he only knows of a few, and the few are the ones he hits you over the head with again and again and again. But what is, and again, that is a temptation to resurrect your sin. That's what the devil wants you to do, is resurrect your past. He wants you to resurrect your pain. He wants you to resurrect your failures. He wants you to resurrect the failures of other people. So if you notice, there might be just about five things that he constantly reminds you of. Isn't that true?
Right.
Yeah? There's not 20 things that he reminds you of. There might be five, okay? And those might be the five that he's privy to. So he loves to get you to agree with something you have already forgiven. And that is called temptation. He is tempting you to question the character of your Father in heaven, who says that if you believe in Yeshua, Jesus the Christ, then as far as the east is from the west, he remembers your sin no more. What does no more mean, Daniel?
It means never again.
It means no more. I've done a study. I've looked it up in the Greek. It means no more. No more. No more means no more. Just as black is black, white is white. No more means no more. So the enemy is simply tempting you to question the character of God, to get you to question the word of the living God, and to get you to question the price that Jesus paid on the cross for you. That's all it is temptation. You have forgiven yourself. You have released yourself. Now you tell the devil to shut up and go to hell where he belongs. How did Jesus answer the temptation of the devil, Daniel?
Get behind me.
Get behind me, Satan. Okay, what else? Remember the 40 days that Jesus, after he had fasted, and then bam, the devil came to tempt him, right? So in the place of weakness, physical weakness is where the devil came to tempt, and Jesus answered him with the word of God. Satan used the word of God to attack him, and Jesus used the word of God to answer him. He answered every accusation with the word of God. And Satan knows the scripture probably better than you and I both do. And he will use the scripture to try to condemn us. But see, Jesus is the one that lifts us up, sets us free. And he says, do not return to a yoke of bondage. I set you free for the sake of being free. Now be free. So when the temptation comes to rehearse your mistakes, to resurrect your failures, you tell that sucker to go to hell because Jesus paid the full price and he remembers my sin no more. And therefore, I do not remember my sin no more, and I will not take on a yoke of bondage. Go to hell, devil, in the name of Jesus. That's how you answer your tempter. Understood?
Amen. Thank you.
Let me pray real quick. Father, thank you so much for Daniel. I thank you for that word. I know that many, I needed to hear that myself. I thank you, Lord, for how clear your word is. And I praise you, God, that as far as the east is from the west, you remember our sin no more. So Daniel, say this, say, Father, forgive me.
Father, forgive me.
For not standing firm.
For not standing firm.
On your truth.
On your truth.
And your character.
And your character.
What you did at the cross for me.
What you did at the cross for me.
Was enough.
Was enough.
So I receive forgiveness right now.
I receive forgiveness right now.
For resurrecting my failures.
For resurrecting my failures.
And the failures of other people.
And the failures of other people.
I release forgiveness over my body.
Forgiveness over my body.
And my soul and my mind.
And my soul and my mind.
Right now.
Right now.
And I release resentment.
And I release resentment.
Off of me.
Off of me.
And off of others.
And off of others.
Right now in Jesus' name.
Right now in Jesus' name.
I take authority over my mouth.
I take authority over my mouth.
And I will proclaim the truth.
And I will proclaim the truth.
That you have set me free.
That you have set me free.
In Jesus' name, amen.
In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you so much, Daniel. I appreciate you. Thank you, Lord God Almighty, for the blessing of Daniel. Thank you for that message as well. Oh my gosh. Okay, well, we are completely out of time for taking more of those prayer requests. Listen, if you have enjoyed today's program, we really want to hear from you. Join us on Facebook. Come over on Twitter. It's Dani Johnson Live. That's D-A-N-I Johnson Live. Come over and say hello. And if you have more prayer requests, you can write them there on Facebook, or you can come over to our website, DaniJohnson.com, and submit. In our support suite, there's a place where you can leave a prayer request there. We are always praying for you every single day, and we will continue to do that. And we're going to have some time again to pray with you and for you again. So please let us know how today's teaching about denying yourself and your selfish desires and picking up your cross and walking with him, that you're going to choose him and choose to be worthy of him by simply professing him and choosing to believe in him, rely on him, cling to him. This is what we must do if we really truly are people of faith, and if we really are truly people who hold up his name wherever it is that we go. Then when we go through suffering, we have to choose to believe in the other side of that cross, the redemption, the cleansing, the purifying, yes, the healing, the victory over our adversary, the punch in the nose to our adversary. I can't stand that pig. Oh, I get tired of being beat up by him. And once I realized that he's the one beating me up, I was like, it's over, it's done, we're finished. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed today. We get to talk to you tomorrow again. Hey, spread the news about today's program. If you just finished it, you can share this program with other people as well through your social media or even email. God bless you. Thanks so much. Have an awesome day.
You've been listening to The Dani Johnson Show. It's our belief that you can live a better, healthier, happier life. All you need is a little encouragement, a different perspective, a positive force in your life. Get that and more on the next Dani Johnson Show.
I remember being homeless and broke and broken in every way and being overloaded with financial pressure, the pressure that I was a failure, the social pressure, everything that I felt like was crashing down on top of me. And at the same time, I felt so alone until I learned the strategies of first steps to success. You have the chance, my friend, to annihilate all of your debt. Think about that. You have the chance to grow your income through your current career or even learning to start a brand new business that will be profitable. You also have the chance for learning how to motivate the people that are in your life that are driving you crazy and how to have significant breakthrough, not only spiritually, but physically, financially, and socially, and business-wise. And so I'm excited to see you at First Steps to Success. It's coming up January 17th through the 19th. Get yourself registered today, 888-757-8880. There's a seat with your name on it, friend. 888-757-8880.